Hi, I'm Steve from HomeDIYElectronics.com, and I'm here today to show you what happens when you overload your circuits. Now, all resistors have two values. The first one is the resistance, measured in ohms. And the other value is the power. In fact, the power rating, how much power can the resistor dissipate? And that's measured in watts. Now, when you put a resistor into a circuit, you normally get a voltage across the resistor and a current flowing through the resistor. So we've got a voltage V across the resistor and a current I flowing through the resistor. So if this is our resistor, we'll call it R. We could measure a voltage across the resistor and a current flowing through the resistor. Now there's a simple relationship between the current, the voltage, and the resistance value of the resistor. We call it Ohm's law, and it is simply voltage is equal to the current multiplied by the resistance. That's all there is to it. Ohm's law, something you probably use every day in electronic engineering. Now, when you pass a current through a resistor, you might find that the resistor gets a bit warm. It might even get very hot to the touch. This is because the electrical current flowing through the resistor, is being converted into power or heat, and that's being dissipated by the resistor, and that's what you experience as heat. Now, we can calculate how much power is being developed in the resistor by using another very, very simple relationship. We can say that the power, P, is equal to the current multiplied by the voltage. It doesn't come much easier than this. The power is measured in watts. W for short, watts. So let's do an experiment. I've taken a 27 ohm resistor and a 9 volt battery, which I've connected across the resistor. But I've also connected an ammeter into the circuit so that I can measure how much current there is flowing. And I've connected a voltmeter across the resistor so that I can measure the voltage across the resistor. And this resistor is a 1/4 watt power rating resistor, 250 milliwatts. Right, here we've got a very simple setup. Consists of a circuit which is one resistor and a power supply, which is a set of batteries here. These are rechargeable batteries, 8 rechargeable batteries, giving us about 9.6 volts if they're fully charged. Might be a bit less than that today. I'm using my old, really old AVO Model 8 multimeter to measure the current that I'm going to put into this resistor. And I'm going to use, I was about to say a modern, but it's a more modern. I bought this one in about 1985. But we're going to use it to measure the voltage across the resistor. Now, before we start, I'm going to use this multimeter to measure the resistance of this resistor. And it's very simple because it's already connected across the resistor. I'll just switch it to ohms. And we can see that it's a 27 ohm resistor. It's measuring 27.2 ohms. All right, I'm going to switch that back to voltage. Now we're going to see what happens when we turn it on. The multimeter, the ammeter, is set to a 1 amp. You probably can't see that, but it's set to the 1 amp range, 1 amp DC. So if the needle moves all the way over, it's 1 amp. I'll just zero that before we start. There we are. Okay. I have no idea what's going to happen when we do this, but I'm going to now make the circuit. Okay, we have about 320 milliamps. You can see our resistor is starting to smoke here, and 9.1 volts. Yes, 9.09. Voltage is going down a little. Our resistor is not liking this at all. And that is because we're overloading this circuit. This is a resistor that is capable of dissipating a quarter of a watt, just one quarter of a watt. That's 250 milliwatts. And I'm guessing that when we do the calculations, we'll find that the power that we are requiring this resistor to dissipate at the moment is in excess of that. Getting a bit less smoke off it now because quite a lot of the paint has already burnt off. I can feel the heat coming off that resistor. It is really quite hot. Far hotter than we would like a resistor to get in our circuits. Making a nice little heater. Ooh, ouch. Mental note, don't touch an overloaded resistor. So what happened there then? We had a resistor. Which was 27 ohms. We had a voltage which was not about 9.1 volts. We had a current. Current begins with a C, not an I. I is the symbol we use. And that was 320 milliamps, or 0.32 amps. Now the power, we can calculate by simply multiplying the voltage by the current. So P equals 9.1 times 0.32, which equals 2.9 watts. So almost 3 watts. Now, if we started off with a 215 milliwatt resistor, then we've exceeded the power rating by 6 times. And all we managed to do was burn the paint off. Well, I was determined to blow this resistor up. I just wanted to see something blow up. So I reached for another battery pack and I put it in series with the one that I'd already got. And this is what happened. Okay, so I really wanted to get this resistor to blow up. So I've added some more batteries. I've added another 6 cells, which should bring the voltage up to about 16 volts. Okay, so we'll see what happens when I connect them. Woohoo, 16 volts, and the resistor is getting hot and it's blown. Okay, well, that was very successful. Well, I feel better now. So what did we have this time? We still had a 27 ohm 250 milliwatt resistor, but this time the voltage that I managed to put across the resistor was 16.4 volts. That gave us a current of 650 milliamps, or 0.65 amps. So to get the power, we multiply the voltage, 16.4 volts, by the current, 0.65 amps, and we get 10.7 watts. So over more than 10 watts, let's say. That is 40 times too much power for that resistor. And as you can see, it got red hot, smoked a lot, it glowed, and then it failed. It went open circuit, and that's it, the end of our circuit. This is Steve Garrett for HomeDIYElectronics.com.